This time Fred has gone too far.
Okay, what now?
He took the desk closest to the window, and company rules state that desk choice goes by seniority. And the last time I checked, I have way more seniority than Fred.
Let's just keep the peace and let Fred have the desk, okay?
But the rules!
The desk choice, Polly, isn't really a rule. It's more of a guideline. Google's search quality rater guidelines aren't exactly rules for what ranks in search, but they still matter a lot for content marketing. Here's why. Mark, why don't you start by explaining what the Google Search Quality Raters guidelines are? And since that's a mouthful, maybe we'll just refer to it as SQRG for the rest of this video.
That sounds like a great idea, Eric. Now, for a number of years now, Google has contracted a group of people who are trained to evaluate the quality of the top search results for a given query. The SQRG is the training manual and handbook for those raters. It helps them understand what Google thinks is a high-quality page that completely satisfies the needs of the reader.
So, do we have access to those guidelines?
We do now. We didn't always. They used to be considered top secret, but a copy always somehow kind of leaked out. Many of us suspected that Google allowed the leaks because they really wanted to be nudging us toward the standards in those documents. But in any case, starting a few years ago, they've made available a public copy of the document each time it's updated.
And what are the search quality raters actually doing?
Well, their job is to help Google's search ranking engineers to evaluate how their algorithms are doing at providing us with the best search results. Their feedback helps those engineers to know where they might need to tweak an algorithm to get better results that will satisfy real human users.
So, do the guidelines tell us Google's ranking factors, at least, or as far as content on a page is concerned?
No, they don't. I mean, at least not in any direct way. The guidelines are not meant to delineate specific ranking factors. In fact, Google's John Mueller emphasized in a recent Webmasters Hangout when he said, "It's not the case that we take the quality rater guidelines and one-to-one turn them into a code that does all of the ranking." However, I think they are still highly useful to any of us who do content strategy or creation for two reasons. The first is they tell us about the kind of pages and content Google aspires to have ranking highly in their results. Now, as John Mueller put it in that same video, they give some idea of where we would like to hit with regards to search. So even if you can't map things in the guidelines one-to-one with specific ranking factors, if you're striving to improve those things, you're closer to becoming a site Google wants to rank well. Now, second, we should always remember that bringing in organic search traffic isn't the only job for our content.
That's true.
It's just as important, and maybe even more important, that our content pages are truly useful, helpful, complete, easy to use for our real human site visitors. Our content is often the first impression someone has of our brand. It's your first salesperson. You should want to present your best face, and the SQRG is really an excellent tutorial on creating high-quality web pages for real humans.
So to finish up, can you share one insight from the guidelines that would help our viewers create better content?
So there's a concept that flows throughout the entire document that I think sums up Google's take on quality content. That's known by the acronym EAT, or EAT, which stands for expertise, authority, or trustworthiness. Now, Google is clear that they use that not all the time. It's more important on sites that are your money or life type sites. But I still believe that focusing on those standards is the most important goal you can have for your content marketing. Let's start with expertise. Your content creators need to know what they're talking about. In the internet age, it's way too easy for people to discover errors or misdirections. Next, work to build authority in your space. This takes time because you have to build a track record of content that both influencers and regular people come to rely on. And finally, be trustworthy. Don't take any shortcuts that could compromise your reputation. Respect your audience, and they will repay you with their attention.
Thanks, Mark. We'll provide a link to Google's Search Quality Raters guidelines in the blog post for this episode. In the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you get every new episode by hitting the subscribe button on YouTube or the link in our episode blog post.
Hey, Mark. Just letting you know that you're, like, parked in my space.
No, I know.
That space is clearly marked with my name on the sign.
Oh, that sign? I didn't consider it a rule. It's more of a guideline.